That. So we want the E sound. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The lam in the word Allah is light because it is preceded by a kasra under the meme. Every time you see the word Allah appear in the Quran, you want to look at what comes before it. Is it a fatha, a dhamma, or a kasra? If it's a kasra, you want the lam to be very light. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. The ra in ar-Rahman and ar-Rahim is heavy and thick because of the fatha above each ra. So each ra is maftuh and should be read in a heavy way. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Ayah number 1. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Qaf is a heavy letter. قُلْ and the lam is light. So we're going from heavy to light. قُلْ أَعُوذُ. Now over here is a word where it is easy to mix up the hamza and the ayn, or it's easy to say a'udhu or a'udhu, but what you really want to do is make the hamza a very distinct hamza and the ayn a very distinct ayn. A'udhu, a'udhu, qul a'udhu. The ayn is two counts long because of the waw here. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. For both of the ba's, you want the E sound, just like the kasra gives the E sound in bismi, بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Now, there's a shadda on top of the noon, which means we want to do ghunna, we want to have a nasal sound held for the noon for two counts. بِرَبِّ. Now, seen is one of the letters of hums, which means when you stop on it, when you give it a sukoon, you want to make sure that breath continues, that air is continuous through your mouth. So let's read the first ayah one more time. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Second ayah, Malikin Nas. The Ma, La, and the Ka all take single harakas, so they should each be one count long. Malikin Nas. Again, over here, we have Ghunna for two counts because of the Noon with the Shadda on top. Ayah number 3. Ilahinas. Now make sure you have the E sound for the Hamza and for the Ha. Ilahinas. And the Lam is two counts long over here. And remember to hold the Ghunna again. So notice how in the first ayah we're ending on the word Anas. Same thing for the second ayah and the third ayah. And we will also see that for the fifth and the sixth ayahs. Ayah number 4. Min sharril waswasil khannas. Min. Over here we have a noon, sakina, followed by a sheen. The rule is ikhfa. What we want to do is hold the noon, hold the nasal sound on the noon for two counts. So you want ghunna. مِن شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ. Ra over here is light because it has a kasra. So it's شَرِّ. If it helps you to achieve the light sound, you can try to grin with your mouth, making your mouth nice and flat. شَرِّ. Make sure the lam here is very clear. You don't want the lam sakina to disappear. So make sure you're actually hitting the makhraj of the lam with the sakina. Sharil, sharil. وَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ. The seen sakina should be read such that the breath and air is continuous, like we mentioned before. Seen is one of the letters of hums. وَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ. Well is a light letter, so it's read as wa, wa, and kha is a heavy letter. Khunnas. Let's read this ayah one more time. Min sharril waswasil khunnas. Two counts on the noon. Ayah number 5. الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس. الذي, this is two counts long over here. يوسوس في, it's two counts long. صدور الناس. صاد is a heavy letter. صو, صو, and دال is light. صدور الناس. Now, if you accidentally make the dal heavy, you will be reading dad probably, sudur, which is incorrect. The dal has to be nice and light. So you're transitioning from a heavy letter, sad, to a light letter, dal. And then the ra, of course, is light because it takes a kasra. So let's read this ayah again. Paying attention, again over here, the noon should be held for two counts of gunna. So this word again is repeated. Waswas. Okay, let's read this ayah again. Alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurinnas. Last ayah. Minal jinnati wannas. Me, make sure you have the E sound for the meme. Minal jinnati wannas. Two counts on the noon and two counts on the noon. So one thing you'll notice in the surah is that there are a lot of ghunnas related to the noon with the shadda on top. For every single ghunna of this type that appears, you want to hold it for two counts. The most correct recitation has each ghunna held for the exact same length, i.e. for two counts. So try your best not to shorten or elongate the ghunnas beyond this number, number two. And for the best reciters, you'll recognize that they hold all their ghunnas for the same length. So let's go through the surah one more time. There's nothing particularly difficult. And a lot of words do repeat, as you've noticed. We have annas, you have waswas. So this is a fairly short surah as well. Let's read it from the top.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas, malikin nas, إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس